All right, so welcome back, everybody, to the live stream where we thought we might be waiting forever to kick off into part two of the vault, but in this case, we don't. Welcome back. This is now Dera versus Empire for the Evo Sports Pro League. Myself, Tubby One, being joined by Siri from SK. And we do get ourselves back inside the game, so we had ourselves a nice little discussion at the end of the last game, which was more along the lines of, oh my god, where's the support items for Empire? We'll see if we're going to get these little suckers up now. We are 33 minutes into the game. So we've got some time, Siri. We've got some time for them to do that. At least they're looking for some farm to get that too. But we're also seeing other support items coming up. Beastmask now, Necrobook, first level.
And we are going to be pretty close to an Agnims on Vino. I believe he's only around 1,000 off. So once he gets that, if they do not have, you know, the pipe mech up by then, they're just going to be in so much trouble.
They really, really need it. Tinker really is going to get himself a sheepstick. He's actually only 800 gold away from completing that. So 800 for the sheepstick, and of course you do have to remember rearm. It will rearm the sheepstick, so you can keep someone basically permanently hexed if you want to. That can shut down the Quop, shut down the Beastmaster, whoever you want to use that on. The only downside is it costs a crap load of mana to do so. And he doesn't really have an excess of that. Like, it's not like Queen of Pain where you look at like, oh, we got Lincoln's Fear as well as a Sheepstick. Then you're going to have a huge mana pool because you're using two ultimate orbs to create that kind of stuff. But in this case, it's like, well, my mana pool is only going to come from my Mystic stuff.
I think Batrider, yeah, he has his pipe on the way, so that's going to be a big, big difference for the Dire team. They really, really desperately needed that pipe.
I'm just praying right now the Bane goes to mech. And just says, you know what, screw it, I can drop my bottle, I can drop my sticks, anything right now. Just get myself that, we need that mech. If that mech is not up for Empire by the time of the next team fight, then Dera will take this and probably take a Rax. Just want to welcome back everybody as well. I apologize if you had yourself a commercial break. Just before you kick back into this one, we're not expecting God to get back into the game that quickly after the last time where he basically disappeared. Oh, that bottom lane is just so impossible for Dera to push on.
Yeah, it's going to be very, very difficult for them to push towers right now unless they take the fight first.
Hmm. Something was going to come down to. Like, initiation. We might even see a Blink deck come up on Art Style. Well, actually, no, he's already got Necrobook. But surprisingly, he doesn't actually have that. You got four stamps around the place, and that might help out for the roar. But to get that blink initiation on Beastmaster with that roar, catch the heroes out, kill them off fast.
Yeah, I think right now that's the one thing that's really holding Dera back, just because in
Hostile.
All of these team
fights. Oh, chicken the wrong thing! That's not what Tinker wanted to do. He chickened the ball. He wanted Art Style, that's the one he wanted, and that would have been enough time to initiate, but he got roared up instantly after that point. Forced himself into initiate, and that's a balls up on the bottom.
Art Style's been doing such a great job in making sure that he doesn't get caught. I mean, like, a couple times he's been nightmared, and he micros his Hawk to take it off almost instantaneously, which gets him in a better position so he doesn't, you know, get picked off by these ganks. So he's actually been doing a very, very, very good job of being conscious of where the team is and should they be close, getting himself out of there.
Yeah, that's why Beastmaster is, well, really on a side lane. He's actually not too shabby just because of that reason. But when it comes to anything, when it comes to we must have the initiation for a team fight, Beastmaster's Hawk does the job. I'm looking for Empire, like all five agree. I was waiting for them to smoke gank. Have we actually got smoke up on this side? Yeah, we got smoke up on Crystal Maiden right now. But I think they're forcing the 5v5. They want Dera to come out and fight him. They're gonna feel confident now. They've got their mech, they've got their pipe up, they don't have their mech. But with the pipe, that's gonna be enough. And Dera, if they want to try and initiate and that pipe hits properly. Well, I mean properly, I mean it hits all five heroes of the Empire side. And there's very little that Dera can do to stop this. You got a double march from the cheese. You want to come in too close for that one, you will die. Venomancer War is the only thing that can stand in that.
Like, even like at the very, very tail end of that single march, NS took about 300 damage just for putting that one ward up on the high ground. So it's really just very impossible right now to fight inside of the march.
Mm-hmm. In the meantime, all the other lanes can be pushed out by Tinker. All he needs to do is just BTTP, BTTP, BTTP. It's great, love it. And Empire just got to try and set up and Tinker can join them when he needs to. I'm wondering if Dara getting a little bit impatient. Callum looks like they want to jump in. That's just... March the machine goes. Dara falls back. Rockets fly out. March the machine goes. Rockets fly. Dara falls back. It'll be this forever tug of war. Hello, SK. He really wants to go this. And there goes the TP in from Tinker. And he will get himself in. But where did Ez... Oh, blink up. Dredd's in trouble in the rear. Shackles trying to land off. It's managed to hold Tinker in place for the moment. And there goes the epicenter. Going to kill off the Yes, it does kill off Ennis in the meantime. Trying to track down God. Enchantress as well as Venomancer is the one to take a fall. There gets a flame break. A little bit out of range. It's a good shackle there from Santa. Manages to finally kill off SK, but SK popped off everything he needed to do so. Rockets will pop again. Santa losing life. One more laser will do the job. Needs to find him first. Four snapped up. Beastmaster comes in. Less off the roar. Tries to buy time, and they're going to buy some very, very good time there too. Tinker buys back into the game instantly. CM dropping down the ultimate. Swain to kill off, and there comes Queen of Pain back up to life again. That's an Aegis the Immortal, which he almost forgot they picked up. Tinker wants the TP out. Axe will clear it off, and he needs to get out of here right now. Flame Break pushes them back, and there's no stun right now that can stop that TP. But a good fight for Dara. They lost the Aegis, but they got a couple of kills back. They hold their tier 2 towers. It's still leveled up.
And now Queen has her sheepstick, so it's going to be... I think that right now, the Dire team is in a good position, but they are steadily losing grounds against Dare. It's going to be very, very difficult now that Quap has a sheepstick, and once Santa gets his up as well. Oh, actually, you know, he isn't even going for one. He looks like he's going for an Orchid. So once they get those up, it's going to be very, very difficult for them to do anything. And also, I just want to mention that was a great, great play by Dredd. As soon as the Batrider blinked in almost instantaneously, he popped off his heal, which is the reason why they not only had to use the Bat ult, but also use the Bane ult. So taking that grip out of play was a very, very good move for him.
I'm watching this bottom lane right now with SK. Artstyle is stalking him. Stalking him so badly. Keeping the Hawk up so he can have that vision. Is even thinking about it. SK even just cops a little bit of damage from the axe. SK now realizes someone is here. Tinker's here as well. There he starts off with a Burrow Strike. Four star Finn. Good shackle. Pulls SK out of that sandstorm. Four staffing away, just trying to get that range. Necro units pop off. Batrider going on Santa. Santa will basically burn to death right now. Tinker's going to come in to help out, but Batrider can finish the job. And Necro units keep on going on Tinker. They say, screw it, and you know what? I'll just keep on farming out the jungle instead. While Queen of Pain pushes out the top lane. SK blink, misses on the Burrow, and the Gale will hit.
This Vino just desperately wants like 70 more gold. He is so close to the Staff of the Master, and I think he definitely, oh my god, I'm sorry, from his Agnums, and I think he definitely wants that before the next team fight.
Hunter. It's fine.
I don't know if you caught it earlier, but actually, when Artstyle killed the Tinker, he shouted out Haunflare. So, pretty funny about that.
Gotta love the rivalry. What game? What game? We all play the same game. It's called Dota. Middle lane. Martian Machine starts off. Arsar loses his board to that as well. Can't even keep it on the front lines. SK wants to go in for an epicenter. And he's got level 3 on that epi now. Just waiting to rock and rumble.
This Batrider is in a great position. He has his level 3 ult up. He has his blink. He can just pick someone up.
The only thing he doesn't have is his pipe. He already popped. He's going to pick up Artstyle, and in comes the epicenter. There goes it as well. They're going to keep Artstyle stunned before he can pop off that pipe, which now he'll be able to do so. But no, they keep him stunned the entire time. Couldn't pop anything up. Great initiation from Empire. Now pick up Santa. One last brain sap will do the job. Flame Break looks like a Unique was hoping he could push back down the Queen of Pain or Venomancer. They didn't do it in the end, but good initiation. Now they've got to see if they can make Dara pay. Tier 2, possible Tier 3.
It doesn't look like any of those heroes have buyback either, so they might be able to take a Tier 3 with this. And again, Bane has reached that 3,000 gold limit again. Let's see what he picks up. It's very interesting just because he's been at this point so many times this game, and every time he's decided on a small item. Like, first time he went back out of 4 staff. Oh, okay, Tinker's just gonna TP out.
Yeah.
Second time, you know, he decided to use it on a buyback and to die again, and so now it's like, what big item is he going to go for?
Mech. Please, for the love of God, a mech. They gotta get a mech up on this squad somewhere. Man. This is a problem now I'm seeing for Empire. Like, that initiation was great. And the main reason why it worked was they shut Artstyle down. There was no pint, there was no necro units. They kept him continuously stunned. Took a lot out of them to do so, and because of that, they couldn't push down any further. Like, you took one tier 2 tower and a couple of kills. That was the entire summary of that. Like, you got 5k XP, 2,000 gold advantage from that. And they're going for Roshan now too, but everyone's up for Dera. Queen of Pain's got her ultimate up in 30 seconds. It's not the best timing for her. But it's just one of these things where if Empire can take this fight, that's awesome. But what more can they do? When does it get to the point where they can push in after having a team fight?
I agree. That's why I think that maybe it would be a better idea for Bane to pick up a, what's it called? To pick up a Necro book. Help them out a little bit with pushes, just because. Or, you know, Tinker could also go with Manta. But
oh, hello. We're looking at Roche Pit. Pipe has already popped from Empire. That's a really, really early pipe. Nightmare now from Venomous. That pipe's going to wear off by the time they want to go for this one. And there goes the roar. And Venomous held in place for the moment. It's a great shackle holding Batrider there too. And there goes the Venom ultimate with the Aghanim's upgrade. Huge fight for Darrow. They pick up Batrider. They pick up CM. They're going to grab the Tinker on the retreat out as well. Sheepsticks are there. And Santa just wants to catch up to anybody. Tinker buys back into the game, so his money is gone. Four star from Bane gets himself out of range. But he was forced to come back. Yep, double buying back, two heroes gone, and now they're going to look for Roshan.
And they can take it. Tinker already went top. He already knows that they're not going to be able to contest that. So it looks like it is going to be an Aeus, the second one in the game, for Dare.
Yeah, I was looking really, really good now. I was a little bit concerned for them, because the initiation was still there from Empire, but then again, I was concerned for Empire too. I was like, how are you going to push in? And this is where the power comes from Dera to push it after a team fight. Two heroes are down. Venomancer starts the wall of wards. Arsar can destroy off creep waves. They're going to have the roar up in a couple of moments' time. Dread kind of needs a creep for the love of all God. How long has it been since we've seen him even micro a creep?
It's been a long, long time.
It's been a very long time. God's walking around. He's got himself a sheepstick. Aghanim. Is he? He's going to go Aghanim's.
He's had that point booster for quite some time, though. So, and he hasn't picked up another piece, so I'm not really sure if he just wants to hold on to that or if he's actually working towards it, because I think he's had that point booster for at least 20 minutes.
It's the normal build right now for all the Shrek's, as well as Queen of Pain. You grab that point booster early on. Oh, SK gets the Burrow Strike up, goes inside the Sandstorm, but there's a Sentry Ward looking at him. Beastmaster lets off the roar. They did not want that Epi going. Flamebreak will push him out a little bit. Pipe does go off. This time for Empire, they're going to cast Droid out, holding him in place. Venomance on the run, there's no ultimate for him, no nothing left. He will go down. 1, 2, 3. Arsar will take a fall for the price of an SK. Well, well worth it for Empire. Now they can push, now they can go.
And just look at that damage from the double march. I don't know if you like were actually, if you like caught that, but that was just the most damage out of any spell in that game, in that fight. That was just absurd how fast everyone went down.
Oh, Santa. Looks like Tinker and Santa's gonna have a little bit of fun inside the trees. Santa heads down south to try to avoid their Martian machines, and great four staff up. Santa needs to keep on running though. Bane is here. Four staff's on cooldown for both Tinker as well as him, so they won't get in range to stop him. But that's wasted time. 25 seconds, and we're gonna have Venom and Enchantress back up again. And they
Beastmaster also has a buyback right now, so if they really do want to contest this, they can. It doesn't even look like they're gonna try to go for that.
Empire has got to find a way to make them pay. Really has to find a way to make them pay. It's one thing to win these fights and get your heroes back up again. Like, the gold advantage is back towards the Radiant. 2,500 their way. Experience is almost 2,500 their way as well. That last... Funny enough, with that fight, the Radiant earned more XP. Like, there was maybe one... That's not even 1k, that's 500 XP Empire managed to achieve during that last fight inside the jungle.
And if you look at NS, you know, I think he's sick of the pipe.
Mid lane, like, well, set up, lasso on Sander, pulling him through the flames. Scandal is here, but in comes God, less off the hex, and what a great shackle! He out even get that angle! That's not even possible! Heavy Sander will now pop, Sander will go down, or will he? Yes, he will walk in the flames, God will take a fall. One for one right now, Windrunner for Bane, now Queen of Pain will pop as well. NS will TP back out of safety, oh no he doesn't, Tinker with one last laser to the rear. Dread is up here, SK on 5 HP. And that was a little bit of overkill there, but Queen of Pain will come in, finish off the Crystal Maiden. SK was brought down by the imp from Enchantress at close range. Does the job nonetheless, and God's going to look now up the middle lane for Arax.
And that really is just like the strength of having all the support items again. You know, they go on Santa. They were hoping just to pick him out of the fight, but he came back because of the mech, because of Nature's Attendance, because of the pipe, and then got off a great chapter that really made that fight possible. With, of course, the buybacks and the Aegis, but...
Shiva's Guard, Rockets, March, and Machine's going to make this really hard for Dera to go in. Top lane was pushed out by Tinker, and they're going to keep on actually just ripping into God. Four-star being the Batrider back in. He needs more space. God goes in, pops up the ultimate. Oh, only just gets hit there on Batrider. God needs to get out. 1 second, there goes the blink. Retreats out, picks off an extra hero. But needs the time to regenerate before he can go in again. Tinker can just hold this off with the March of the Machines. He kind of wants to go on Artstyle, but Artstyle, he has too much life at this point. Not to mention, increase that. He's got plate mail himself, and Shiva's Guard for him is actually not that far off. So Shiva's for both sides.
And this is exactly what we were talking about, you know? Like right there, after they picked off that bat, they really only had Tinker up, but even just with the solo Tinker, it's so difficult to push with the March and the Rockets and the double March. It's just so very difficult to go into those choke points and do some damage to the towers.
It's always hilarious. It's kind of normal when Queen of Pain has an Agate Inceptor to pop her ultimate off to get farm and creep wave, but it's still hilarious to watch. And I'm actually wrong. Beastmaster is not going to go for Shiva's. He's going to Assault Cuirass. Got Hypersone off for Artstyle now.
Which I think is a really good option for them. It'll help them take down some towers. It'll give them a little bit more protection. And also, just because I think that they really need a little bit more to help them take the towers, because counter-pushing is just so difficult for them right now because of the Tinker. So, I mean, once I get that up, you know, it's going to double up with the Inner Beast, which is actually very interesting that he didn't go a Django. They still have no drum, which is a little peculiar here.
What do we actually have? Like, support items-wise, look at the items. Venomancer, Veil. We've got four staff on Santa. I'm not going to count the Orchid as a support. We've got Mech up for Dread with Mana Boots. Necro units as well as Pipe for Beastmaster. Nova towards Empire, we've got Dyer's Ghost Scepter, four staff. Drums, Pipe. We've now also got another four staff, Dyer's Mana Boots. They're still missing that Mech.
I mean, it's very, very funny how they still don't have it, but I really think that it's very, very strange that they wouldn't get a Django just because, you know, they're already going for the AC aura, they're going for the, they have Inner Beast aura, and yet they aren't interested in the Django aura, so that's very strange.
I'll bring up something else interesting as well, the fact that I think Tinker was planning on going Shiva's Guard. It was the reason for the ultimate orb to start with. But now it's like Batrider's got one. Do we really want to go double? What does Tinker go for his next item? He's got 5.2k. I think he's just making sure he has enough money so he can buy back, which is definitely important for him. If he can control the lanes, then Empire keep themselves in this game. But it's just one of these things of like, what is his next item? What does he try and go with this? Does he look at Lincoln's? Does he look at something along those lines? Or what's the GO?
I think it might not be a bad idea for him also to maybe get like a Manta, because right now they have, once they win the team fights, they aren't able to do anything. I mean, they won a huge team fight and bottom tier 2 tower was already low and they didn't even want to go for it just because they're like, look, we don't have the DPS, how are we supposed to take this down? So having a Manta on Tinker might be able to give them a little bit of an edge as far as pushing these towers, because that's really what this is coming down to. I mean, we're at 51 minutes, almost 52 minutes.
Schmalk. Unique's going to spot him off first, blinks himself away, still going to get shackled towards a tree. CM is here, and there goes SK! Preps himself up, but the FB Center is doing very little when Arsenal already preps up the roar, and what a great quap ultimate! Straight through them all with the Venomancer combined. Batrider is lassoing Arstyle up, but he's already popped off everything he needs to. Tinker four stabs out, leaves the Martian Machines rolling. Arstyle taking a little bit of damage from that flame break, might also be enough to kill him. They need to get a little bit more, and Bane is in here. Four stabs himself up, he gets a double kill. Same with Tinker and Dera actually lose out on this fight.
That was a great fight from Empire. Also, the Vino just did so much damage with that Veil Ags ult, but they had no finishing blows. The Sand King, I believe, was at literally 1 HP just because it's not fatal, so that did quite some damage.
I love how the fact that Empire did that, I looked at this initiator in the fight, it's like, you know what? Dara's got this. The pipe popped off, right? Necro units, yeah, you keep them up as long as you possibly can. This can work out perfectly for them. But Empire, they just couldn't kill them. And the like of deaths means now Empire, they've got a long time to push in here. 15 seconds before Enchantress and Venomancer come up. Queen of Pain is here, but she won't want to go in on that. And the bottom lane's also being pushed out as well. SK is giving that most of the momentum, and they've got double siege creep. You couldn't have asked for a better time for Empire to go for a counter push. Already the blink in. They find out God, Rockets, Shivas, SK, Burrow, Strike. Will it be enough? God, Venomancer is here. He has the ultimate. Less off the Gale. Pops the ultimate. Pipe is popped off here from Empire. And they want to try and finish off Venomancer, but God buys back into the game. Quap ultimate, almost enough to kill off Batrider. They're holding onto this rack as much as they can. Batrider will go down. The infinite is off the last hit. God needs to retreat back out again. Bane trying to pop off. Anthony's got, he's got his ultimate back up again too. Bottom lane's managed to hold. Dread's on the hunt. The heal from him is trying to catch up. Power shot will fly through. They cannot get the vision. Scandal's just way too fast for those phase boots. Stops for a moment to suck on a bottle.
Here's a haste rune also.
Okay, that'll also help out. I was thinking, wow, that's really fast haste. really fast phase boots, but that'll work.
Phase boots now giving a 200 Musu bonus.
Hell yeah, most OP item in the game. But Dara defend that, and they don't lose a Rax. The melee stays up. They lost a tier 3 tower. They're really going to be counting their lucky stars for that. Hang on, is Dre getting a creep? No, he can't. 2 seconds. No, he can. He isn't even grabbing one. Dre would rather farm. And the reason why is he wants his Aghanims, which he now has. 55-minute Aghanims. He does go Lincolns?
He does get Lincolns, and he still has 5,000 gold in the bank. And so did Bane. Bane is also at 5,000 gold. So they just have so much money right now.
Maybe they're just preparing. They're thinking, you know what? This will be a 90-minute game. I need buybacks. I need buyback money. It does cost him a lot though, like Bane, he's gonna have 2k, at least 2k when he dies. Or else he can't buy back.
His current buyback cost is
1800. Yeah.
He does have 1600 reliable gold though, so I think under any circumstances, even if he did buy an item right now, he would be okay as long as he keeps himself above the gold limit.
This I like from SK. BTs for him. This is now... Empire are changing the playing field. Complete change the playing field until CM just gets killed off. But she's CM. She could die. Sacrificial lamb. But no matter what happens now for Dara, if they want to push in, they've got to deal with SK pushing the bottom lane. Tinker's dealing with the top lane. They're going to grab up Roshan right now. That's be great for them. But to take a team fight, they cannot do it. They must fall back. SK is now going to start getting some right clicks in on this tier 3 tower. And Dara will be forced to TP back. And all he needs to do is just blink and TP. 18 seconds left on the cooldown for that one, so he can't get caught out during that time. But it's a really smart play from Empire. Turn this into a map control battle, which they will excel at. And they even bait out the Venomancer ultimate on the top lane.
Especially with the Tinker, you know, they just have so much control. The funny thing is, also, we were commenting earlier on how the Tinker had his boots of travel and then was also holding onto a TP scroll, and the same king is doing the same thing. So, maybe it's a secret Empire strat that we in the Dota world are not aware of yet.
They stick with the Boy Scout rule of Dota. Always carry a TP scroll at all times. There is no excuses, even if you have BTs.
For those people that were asking, two things. First is, it is a bug. TP does share cooldown with bots, so even though it didn't show it, it is on cooldown. If you tried to use it, it wouldn't work. Second thing is, right now, Lincoln's is refreshed by Rearm. So anytime someone tries to use a spell on him, as long as he has his Rearm up, he will be okay. So that's why Lincoln's is so powerful on Tinker.
He does actually finish up the Shiva's Guard as well. So he gets Lincoln's and Shiva's. It's kind of essential too. The pushing power you get from the Shiva's. Pop off two Shiva's Guards and you basically destroy a creep wave if you pop off right, not like you did just then. Dara's looking for some kills. They're smoking through and they're going to see Tinker TPing him. And they'll initiate on him instantly. Shackle doesn't lash, but the Beastmaster Roar is there. How much life does he have? How much armor does he have? It's not going to be enough. Go Scepter. March on the Machine is doing what it can. It's going to buy him some time, and Venomancer will kill him off. Tinker buys back into the game. They're looking at Roshan. Or not, at least around the Roshan pick. Crystal will take a fall. SK, Burrow strikes. Effie does well. A lot of damage. Arsal. There goes the cheese from Santa. Bring him back up again. The pipe had already been popped. Scandal, Rockus will now pop Tinker is here. Batrider tries to TP out to safety, will knock it out in time. Queen of Pain gets the last right click on for that one. Even the Dynast Courier is taking a fall right now. Empire's on the run back towards the Tier 2 tower. Standard with his own BKB is just warning this kill. God turns him into a piglet. Now focus firing down on piglets. The hate is there on the farm animals. Standard wants to finish off the job, imping him up, mounting him up. SK is the last one left alive. And Dara, well, they cannot push. Look at the top lane. Unless they say, you know what? Tier 3 towers, they'll deal with it. In fact, they will do so. Push the middle lane, take a rank is what they need right now.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Look at even the damage coming out from God. He's loving it. Crystallis for him. Increasing the crit, pushing in on the towers, the fortification trying to buy some time for Empire. But they're out of time. Dara's going to go for the GG. They're going to get straight for the GG while Tinker is down.
And they can do that. I mean, with the ACR and Inner Beastar, they are just so powerful, especially because Necronomicon's back up. It's interesting that this Bane is not buying back. They don't have a glyph. Bane has 5,000 gold.
Well, there's nothing he can really do in the end. SK has no ult. Well, actually, SK does have his ultimate, so they possibly could have done something, but they just admitted defeat. 58 minutes and 55 seconds.
It's just very, very strange, because this entire game, he's had just very large amounts of gold. You know, 3,000 twice, 5,000 for at least the last 7 minutes now. He bought no items, and when he died, he didn't buy back. So I'm not really sure what the plan is with that.
Well, the plan is for us right now, we're going to have ourselves about a 20-minute break, depending on when the next game wants to start up. AL versus Moscow 5 is your last game for the evening. It is a best of two, however, so your last game is a doubleheader. So stick around, guys, and we'll be back for more action. Of course, we are covering the EVO Sports Pro League. That was Dara versus Team Empire. Still got to give props to Team Empire for the game they pulled off. And Dara, back to the drafting board for everything else they're going to do as well. Got to hone those skills if they want to keep on being up there in the top teams. We'll be back here in a couple of moments. Game number, well, it's 3, but technically it's the second game for the evening. Coming up soon.